Hello viewers, Sensex has just breached 42,000 on the upside and it is climbing lifetime highs day after day. Are your mutual fund portfolios reflecting this trend? Many people come and complain to me telling that their mutual fund portfolios are not generating the returns according to the way the Sensex is moving. In this episode, I am going to bring to you answers why your mutual fund portfolio is dragging behind. Dear viewers, this is NRI Money Clinic for you and I am Dr.Chandrakanth, but practicing investment consultant and a financial planner. It is an attempt to impart financial literacy. There is no hype here, it's just the right advice.
NRI Money Clinic. No hype, just the right advice.
So dear viewers, it's very difficult to believe. Sensex has climbed 42,000 and the mutual fund portfolios most people have got are not reflecting this trend that the Sensex is showing. Yesterday, one of my important clients, he asked me, Dr. Bhat, can we have a relook at our mutual fund portfolio? I feel something is not working there. Can you have a relook at it? I said, okay, fine, let's go ahead. And I did review of the whole mutual fund portfolio and it did not show me anything wrong. Then I explained to him what exactly is the thing which is happening. Let me do it for you now. To understand this divergence, the Sensex is climbing lifetime highs, whereas the returns that our portfolios are showing in the mutual fund is not reflecting this trend. Why does it happen? I can pinpoint four main causes for this non-performance of the mutual fund portfolios you might be having. Point number one, which is the most important one, is divergence in the markets. What is this divergence? To understand this divergence, we need to understand what Sensex is made out of. The Sensex, what we call as the Bombay Sensex 30 stocks index, consists of only 30 stocks. Even within the 30 stocks, the top 5 stocks, Reliance Industries, HDFC Bank, HDFC, Infosys, and one another stock, collectively account for roughly 50% of the Sensex valuation. The remaining 25 stocks reflect the remaining 50% of the Sensex value. What does it mean? It means if there is an up move in this first 5 stocks alone, the Sensex can move up. The figures that you see in the Sensex values can move up or down depending on the movement of this first 5 stocks. Now, if you carefully analyze, during the last 6 months, these 5 stocks have moved up drastically up and they are pushing the Sensex upwards. Now, if you look at the broader markets, the market what the stock market is reflecting has more than 1,000 odd stocks which are traded day in and day out. Out of this, only these 30 stocks are reflected on the Sensex. If you look at a mutual fund portfolio, a typical mutual fund portfolio will have anywhere from 40 to 80 stocks. So the mutual fund portfolio what you are carrying is not restricted to the 30 stocks which are reflected on the Sensex. So while the Sensex is moving up, if the remaining stocks are not catching up as they should be along with the Sensex, then there is a chance that your portfolio is not catching up with the Sensex figures. This is the primary reason. The devil is in the details, as I said. While the Sensex represents the 30 top stocks, there are other indices on the Bombay Stock Exchange as well. Which are these indices? There are many of them. I will discuss 2 indices for your understanding. Now, Sensex has moved from roughly 36,000 or so, about 6 months behind, and has moved up to 42,000 today. It had done a peak valuation somewhere around January 2018 or so. around the same time, that's January, February 2018, the mid-cap index was at about 21,000 odd figure at that point of time. But where is mid-cap index today? The mid-cap index, what you are seeing today, is roughly 15% below the lifetime high. So this is what I call it as a divergence. Sensex is climbing the lifetime highs, whereas the mid-cap index is still 15% below the previous highs it made in January 2018. Now let us look at the small-cap index. Now the small-cap index made its lifetime high in the month of January 2018. It was at about 9,000 levels. Where is it today? Today it is at about 6,000, or roughly about 30% lower than the previous lifetime highs. Now, if you have exposures to mid caps and the small cap funds in your portfolio, obviously they will not reflect the Sensex trends. So now a well-constructed mutual fund portfolio obviously will have a mixture of large cap funds, it will have mid cap funds, it will have small cap funds, it may have hybrid funds of various grades, it may have debt funds, and all kinds of funds could have been mixed in your mutual fund portfolio. Because of this divergence, obviously your mutual fund returns as things stand today will not reflect what's happening in the Sensex. If this is what you are worried about, this has nothing to be worried about in your portfolio. It's perfectly a normal situation. Just a small word of caution here. These observations pertaining to the mutual funds which are well created. If your portfolio is not doing well, but the portfolio construction is perfectly in order, then you have nothing to worry about. Now that I explained to you what could be the reason in a well-constructed portfolio for it not to reflect the returns that the Sensex is showing, let's look at the problems in other kinds of portfolios. So the point number two is, if your portfolio is not constructed well, then that itself can be the reason for your portfolio not to function like a normal portfolio. As I said, your portfolio should follow a particular pattern. It should have large exposure to the large caps, a sprinkling of mid caps and the small cap portfolios, and you can always incorporate other kinds of funds depending on your risk profiling, depending on the circumstances you are passing through. But if your portfolio is not constructed on a scientific basis, now forget about today's situation of Sensex at 42,000, then under any circumstances, your portfolio may not perform at all. So there is a need for you to check whether your portfolio is constructed correctly or not. If you have a doubt in your mind, if your portfolio is performing correctly or not, if you are in a doubt, please comment in the section below here and let me cover this particular points in my future videos as well. So reason number three, most people get attracted to the stock markets when the markets are doing very, very well. Those of you who have been investing in the stock markets for the last 3-4 years very well know what happened 2 years before when the markets made lifetime highs. The mid-cap funds, the small-cap funds, the micro-cap funds were fashion of the day. People brought in large amounts of money and invested as a lump sum in these small caps and the mid caps funds. This was happening day in and day out around that particular time. If your portfolios have gone down because of this mistake that is done at your end, pumping in large lump sum amounts of money in the mid caps and the small cap funds, then I'm afraid it will take a really long, long time for your portfolio to come back to their normal shape. It will not recover that soon. Yes, given the time, they will come back, but it would definitely take a long span of time for them to come back to the healthy levels in future. Point four, over diversification of your portfolio. This is reason number four. Most people fear investing in the mutual funds. They think if they do not diversify properly, they may lose money. Yes, diversification is a proven tool to minimize your risk, but over-diversification reduces the return of your portfolio. What is really required is an intelligent concentration of your portfolio without affecting diversification. If you try to diversify too much, then what happens is the returns that you get gets averaged out. And the funds which do well are offset by the funds which did not do well, and your portfolio returns will not reflect the trends that are happening in the marketplace. So over-diversification is another reason why your mutual fund portfolio may be not doing well. So dear viewers, if your mutual fund portfolio is not performing well, to summarize, what could be the reason? Reason number one, divergence in the performance of various indices like the Sensex, the mid cap index and the small cap index. Point number two, improperly constructed mutual fund portfolio. Point number three, having invested in the small and the mid caps a large lump sum amounts of money during the previous lifetime highs achieved in the January 2018. Point number four, over-diversification of your mutual fund portfolios. So dear viewers, if you like the subject that I discussed today, please like this video, share it with your near and dear ones, subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified whenever I release my next video. Thank you very much for watching this episode on NRI Money Clinic. Thank you.
Press the bell icon for more details and subscribe our channel.